4 days until Christmas. All the engines on the island of Sodor were very busy. There was plenty of jobs to be done and plenty of passengers needed to go places, no matter what the weather.
Driver tells me that there's snow on the way, said Emily.
That means snowploughs are ready, said Murdoch.
Ahoy, and young Thomas will be looking forward to that, won't you, Thomas? Said Salty. You know I won't, grumbled Thomas. I don't like wearing my snowplough. And he puffed away with a hoof.
The next day, the Fat Controller came to see him.
Thomas, your snowplough is currently being repaired. In the meantime, you can borrow our brand new snowplough.
Thomas looked at the new snowplough and scoffed.
It looks even worse than my old one, he said.
Now, Thomas, said the Fat Controller, I know you don't like wearing your snowplough, but you'll be quite surprised with this one.
And the Fat Controller was right. As Thomas was clearing the snow, he found it very easy. And it wasn't long until he reached Biggerstown.
Well, Thomas, said his driver, what do you think?
It's brilliant, said Thomas. It's even better than my old one.
Okay, they are fantastic, said a voice.
It was Donald coming in the opposite direction.
These snowplows are fantastic. We should ask the Fat Controller to get some more.
Driver, said Thomas, is there any more jobs than we need to do?
The only other job we need to do is take Terence to clear some roads along your branch line, said his driver.
Meanwhile, Dart was taking supplies to the diesel works. He was running late and was trying to make up for lost time. He raced into the tunnel. Then it happened.
I want diesel fuel,
he said.
I'm stuck.
And he was. Meanwhile, Thomas and Terence had just finished off clearing some roads along Thomas's branch line when the Fat Controller came to see them.
Thomas, Dart has got stuck in some heavy snow. We need you and Terence to dig him out.
We're on our way, said Thomas, and they set it off. The snow was thick and very hard to get through, but they managed. It wasn't long until they found Dart.
Thank goodness you're here,
said Dart.
Don't worry, Dart, said Thomas. We'll get you out.
Terence got straight to work at once. Thomas took all the wagons straight to the diesel works and then came back and helped pull Dart out of the snow. And then they all set it off for home. When they reached Tidmouth Sheds, Thomas shunted the snowplough into the siding and all the engines were put to bed. As they were sleeping, Thomas hoped that there would be more snow tomorrow so he can go out and clear the tracks with his new snowplough.